How many times have you heard somebody say, the old me might have done that, or I'm not the person I used to be, or I'm half the man I used to be? How many times have you heard people say, I'm a new person, I'm a new me, or the new me would never do that, right? We hear these phrases all the time. I think, guys, that it's really a whole lot more literal than people really think that it is. And here's what I mean by that. How many folks do we know that have ever tried to pick up an exercise routine and they get excited about it and they go after it for a week or two and then they just kind of fade off? Or people that say they're going to lose weight and they lose 20, 30, 40 pounds and then they just seem to gain it right back a few weeks later. Or somebody commits to a new business or income goal and they tend to achieve in the direction of that, at least for a period of time, and then they kind of, they lose whatever they've managed to accumulate or whatever promotion they've managed to get. Why do people do that? Why do people tend to return to the original state that they were in when they made decisions to change their lives? And the answer is because they changed the outer world, but they never changed their inner world. They never changed their self-concept. They never changed their self-image. They never changed how they look at themselves, how they see themselves. And this is really critically important. You have to know that you can't operate contradictory to what your self-image says you are or that you'll do or that you'll behave like. You behave like the image you hold in your mind of yourself. That is the truth. And there's no way around it. That's the real... I was about to use a word I shouldn't use. That's the real challenge of this situation. Is that you can't get around it. And you see it. The reason why people gain weight and then lose it. The reason why people go to gyms and then stop going. The reason why these things happen is because they haven't changed who they see themselves as. They've willed the behavior into place. But the will only lasts so long. But where you see evidence that changing the self-image can totally change someone's life is when you meet someone who says, maybe you meet someone who used to lie and manipulate a lot, and now they've impeccable integrity, and you talk to them and they say, yeah, I'm not that kind of person anymore. Or I'm not the kind of person that does that kind of thing anymore. You see, just those words, I'm not that kind of person, or I am the kind of person who, those words are so incredibly telling, because what those words tell you when you hear someone say them or when you hear yourself say them is it tells you that's how you see yourself. See, you can be overweight, for example, and lose 40 pounds. And when someone says, hey, great job, and you lost 40 pounds, you go, yeah, it was really hard, man. I don't know how I'm going to keep it off. You're probably not. But when somebody says, hey, you lost 40 pounds, great job, and you go, yeah, you know what? I'm the kind of person that when I lose weight, I keep it off. If you can say that and mean it and feel it and build that vision in your head, you'll keep it off. If you begin to see yourself as a skinny person, you'll remain skinny. This sounds like mumbo jumbo, guys. I get it. But you need to know this is reality. Your self-image determines how you operate, respond, the decisions you make, every course of action you take. So how do you work on your self-image? How do you change how you see yourself? And the answer is you have to overwrite all of the programming that has given you the self-image that you have today. And so begin to tell yourself things like, I am, and again, I laugh at this because I remember that song from Beck, I'm a driver, I'm a winner, things are going to change, I can feel it. No, you got to say that stuff to yourself. You really do. You have to start telling yourself different stories. You have to start speaking to yourself differently. You have to be the voice in your head that is your greatest encourager, your greatest cheerleader. And you have to start saying things like, I am the kind of person that turns away dessert. Or I am the kind of person that dedicates time to my wife and family. I am the kind of man who would never run around on my wife. I am the kind of woman that would never run around on my husband. I am, You've got to say these things. You've got to say, I am the kind of person that follows through. I am the man who does what he says. I am the woman who is there when I say I would be. I'm always on time. You've got to say these things to yourself. And if you say them often enough, they'll become reality in your life. And when you start believing those things to be true about you, all of your behaviors, all of your decisions, all of your actions will reflect those beliefs. And then in time, you'll be able to look back and go, I truly am a different person. The person I was before might have done this, but the person I am today doesn't operate that way. And that's when you know you've changed your self-image. And that's when you know change is permanent. That's the dose, guys.
Make it a great one.